Hello everybody, this is Andy, and welcome to episode 17 of GregTech New Horizons. And, well, one, you're seeing some changes because I've done a little bit of designing on what I want the base to eventually look like, and I think we're going to have these little pathways that lead places. This one is a little blocked by the stuff that we already have here, but it'll move as soon as we get into AE. Like I was saying at the end of last episode, we're going to start working our way towards AE, and most of this stuff is what we have to do. I didn't just do building in between episodes. I also did a little bit of batch crafting that we needed to have done. I got these from loot bags. I made like another stackish of these, and then I made 28 of these. So we should have enough to get at least partway to the AE system with all of this. However, we have a lot to do. Before we do that, let me explain what's going on in my inventory. You might be noticing, I don't have a lot of things, and, well, I did upgrade my tools, or I was working on upgrading my tools, and then I tried to clear ground items, and, I type slash clear, and when you type slash clear, you destroy everything in your inventory. Couldn't get it back, couldn't, reload a backup, because there are no backups, and, I just kind of screwed myself. So, basically, I just kind of went through and gave myself a couple of things that I had. I did some creative modifier stuff to get these tools back to where they were. I threw away some stainless steel to get this stainless steel pickaxe, and we're looking pretty good. I think everything was just about where it was. If not, it's slightly below where it was, but, you know, it's quite alright for now. If I ever come across anything that absolutely needs to be replaced that I crafted a long time ago, I will probably just go into creative mode and give myself it because, you know, it's, I don't know. I guess I was trying to cheat by clearing ground items, but, like, I was digging and it was annoying, so I wanted to clear them. Whatever. Anyways, first things first, since I've done the batch crafting for those, I also ended up making a couple of these HV tier circuits, which are going to go into the most few, or the few first important things. That's going to be an MV circuit assembler, because that requires HV tier stuff, as well as an implosion compressor. Actually, I am going to need one more, so let me gather up the stuff to make one more HV circuit, and we also need to make this clean room multi-block. Also, the loot bag I just got just gave me a solar... The loot bag I got for making these HV tier circuits, it gave me a solar engine. So, if we decide to ever do any more stuff with Steve's carts, like making a automatic farm with Steve's carts to harvest up like stuff for this thing, that'll come in handy. And I did just throw in a batch of stuff into our brewery, so we are going to make another maybe stack and a half of stuff in there, which will be very useful come later in the next episode or two. And there we go, just a little bit of microcrafting later, and we have the MV circuit assembler, which is real, real good. I also went ahead and extended this line by putting a battery buffer right here, because we are losing a little bit of voltage down this, so this will just make sure the machines will run for a while, even if they're, you know, not getting the most amount of energy. So, this thing should be available. Okay, I'm gonna need a fluid extractor for this thing as well, but we will deal with that later. In between episodes, I also went ahead and cooked up another stack or so of stainless steel. I just made some polyethylene sheets. I have some more annealed copper, which will come in handy. That's just normal copper. I'll put annealed copper on the wall, might as well. Where do I keep this? Apparently that's all my annealed copper, so cool. However, now that we have stainless steel, it is feasible, I think, to start making HV machines. Well, I'm not going to make any HV machines because I would need to make HV generators, and that's just not going to happen right now. We're going to use these MV energy input hatches, just two of them on all the multi-blocks, to get HV stuff. Actually, yeah, probably that. But now that I've got a bit of stainless steel, let's go ahead and make our very first of the HV machine holes, which is the first quest in the HV tab. Okay, there we go. So now we're unlocking more things. Have we unlocked the Applied Energistics tab yet? No, we have not. But that is completely okay. I also went ahead and completed some of these quests. We had all the stuff for it. I mean, I hadn't blasted up any silicon, but it was really, really easy now that we have our blast furnace running at HV. The one thing we still are yet to do in this MV tab that is actually like required, besides making a couple of these machines that I will do eventually, not right now. We don't really need them. Unless I need them, I'm not going to make them and this extruder quest is just very stupid. We are going to need to make these empty plastic boards to make better circuits, which is kind of the goal of this entire episode. So we're going to need to start producing, I think, chlorine, and then we'll probably turn it into hydrochloric acid, and then make iron 3 chloride, because that's just made with a bit of hydrochloric acid, a bit of iron, and it's twice as efficient as the sodium persulfate, or whatever it is. And that HV machine hole is going to go directly into... Wait, what did I do wrong? Oops, I was looking at the wrong machine. Looks like I... Wait, where did it go? There it is. Okay, I need 2 stainless steel rotors. That's really, really easy. I just need 10 stainless steel. And there we go. That is the clean room controller. However, that's just the beginning. It's only one part. We're going to need 2 pressure plates, which I think I have a couple of these, right? I think I have exactly 2 of them. Oh, I have 7. Perfect. Okay, we're going to need a reinforced door as well, which is... That reinforced door requires an MV assembling machine for the dense lead plate. It requires a circuit on 9, as well as 9 lead ingots. And this is probably going to take a moment, so let's make all the other stuff for it as well. And I went ahead and crafted most of the other things, because watching people craft stuff isn't fun. The only thing we have left to do is make the plascrete, which has to be made in an assembler at MV, which we can do perfectly fine. However, we need to make some of this stuff. Polyethylene, fine, we have a bunch of that. Black steel, annoying, but we can make it. This stuff is gonna have to be made in an LV mixer with a bunch of all of this. So I had most of the components for concrete. I already have 9 and some change buckets of it. I'm just centrifuging down some crushed ore to get the stone dust, because it's actually one of the harder things to get for some reason. I'm also macerating some calcite that I bought from the coin shop to get more calcite, and I'll do some more clay just to get more clay. Quartz sand is super easy. I just need to pulverize some sand. So we're getting some concrete. The next step is slightly harder. We need black steel dust, which is made from all of these things. Main issue here, black bronze dust. Black bronze dust is made from all of these things. So let me make a couple stacks of black bronze and then we'll be ready to go. Okay, there's a ton of black bronze. And here is some black steel. That's actually not enough. We're about 12 short, which means I'm short on nickel. And do I have a couple pieces of nickel left? Nope, looks like we might need to go mine that vein again. I went ahead and mined another stack or so of nickel from the nickel vein. It wasn't that hard. I did die once though, but you know, everything's fine. Don't worry about it. Oh wait, I actually need this in dust form. Oh, I can just pulverize that right here if I throw these things off the table, just like that. And I should just be able to choose to turn this into black steel. Okay, there, that is enough. I needed just one more craft, and we should be going. It does take slightly longer than I would hope, but that's alright. Okay, it is many hours later. I have allowed all of our black steel to cook up. I also made half the amount that we needed, so I had to make some more, and I just went ahead and did that off camera, but there we go. That should be the 82 that we need. Now we just need to bring it over to this very special assembler with the things that we need in it, and slowly but surely, it'll make some plascrete. Is it plascrete? Is that really what it's called? Yep, it's called plascrete. I assume it's like plastic concrete type thing, but you know, weird word. Anyways, let's put a chest right there, and my wrench is still in the crafting table, so let me grab that, and I'll go ahead and just auto-export into the chest, and everything should craft up slowly, but, you know, fine. While everything crafts up over there, it's going to take a couple minutes, let's go ahead and set up the basis for our clean room. So actually, let me grab a couple of those plascrete blocks because they'll be useful in setting up at least a couple of things. So I have a very nice 5x5 room. That's how big our clean room is going to be. It's going to be a 3x3 interior, and this just happens to be 5x5, and it's on an odd thing, so we can put the door directly in the center. So I need a plascrete right there. I think I need this right here, and then probably this on the inside and on the outside, because I don't think you can open this with just your hand. Nope, you cannot. And then I'm gonna need a controller. I think this goes on the top center. Yep, that's right. The controller goes top center, right there. And then these are slow to break, but they can be harvested, which is perfectly fine. I guess they're not meant to be broken with pickaxes. Oh, it must be... No? That's very weird. It doesn't say it's currently harvestable with the pickaxe. Whatever. Doesn't really matter. Filters around the rest of the center. And then most of, or I think the rest of it's just like plascrete and these other things. So we're going to have an energy hatch. That's going to give energy into the multi-block. And then we can pass items and energy and fluids in through MV machinals. So let's go ahead and pass all of those things through from... I think we'll do it just along the back right here, so we should be able to access them from the inside. I don't quite know which way they're supposed to face, but I think that will probably work just fine. I'm going to need to get a combustion generator over here, and we'll power it just, I guess, right there. That should be fine. Actually, I think I'm going to go ahead and put it over here, so that way, if I point this downwards... Yep, I can point it downwards. Well, we can put a combustion generator just like right here, hide it in the ground, and put a little energy thing right there. The last important piece is the maintenance hatch, which I'm going to put directly at the center, just above one of these plascrete blocks. And that should be the general setup. The rest just needs to be filled in. So I think it has to be... I think it has to be solid. I don't know. Let me wait for those plascrete blocks to get finished up. Let's actually check how they're doing. Slowly but surely, not quite done. But let's go ahead. I'm going to see what I can do. So what I can tell from the quest book is plascrete blocks are required for all edges, which means I'm going to have to rethink this power situation slightly. I'll probably just put a wire right here and maybe put a cover on it later because that works good enough for me. But we're slowly finishing up, and it's starting to look kind of nice, kind of fancy. It's going to fit perfectly, snugly into this room right here, which is really cool. While we're slowly finishing up, this circuit assembler is essentially useless outside of the clean room. So let's go ahead and move that bad boy into here. There is nowhere for it to get power or anything yet, but it's definitely going to exist. Alright, everything should be hooked up, and I went ahead and sent power to these guys. This is the combustion generator that powers the actual clean room, and this is the combustion generator that is going to power our circuit assembling machine in here once we hook it up. However, if we put these last four in, it should form the multi-block, and it looks like it did. Yep, that. Do I have to click them for some reason? Maybe these are facing the wrong way? Or it requires maintenance. Okay, turns out it just needed to have maintenance run on it through the maintenance hatch, which is perfectly fine. So every 5 seconds that I don't have the door open, we get another percentage of efficiency, which you can see down there, and I assume you want that to get to 100%, because 100% is good. But this thing looks like it's going to be a passive use of fuel for approximately forever, which is less cool. Let's worry about that in a little bit, and claim these very cool loot bags. And what did I get from here? Large battery hole, some... Oh my goodness, that's actually really good. I was considering trying to make these, because these are a really, really, really good source of biodiesel. So we're going to want to level that up, probably. And a little bit of string. So, yeah. These are really, really good. I just went ahead and... Oh. I forgot to take that down, apparently, when I was running my wire. I went ahead and tucked them in here, so we should never even, like, consider losing them again. Well, I mean, I did kind of clear my inventory at the beginning of the episode, so I guess maybe we will potentially have problems, but that's fine. Okay. Now that we have that clean room up and running, we can technically make these better circuits right here. However, we are going to have to make these plastic circuit boards, which require plastic circuit boards, and this is going to be... And I think, wait, this is simple, right? Yeah, this is just an LV chemical reactor, and it makes one at a time. Not very cool. We're also going to need to make this iron 3 chloride. That is going to be the main issue. So we're going to need to start making chlorine, and we already make hydrogen. So we need to make hydrochloric acid in a, not that, chemical reactor at LV. The first step is going to be using an advanced mixer to mix salt water or salt into water to create salt water. So we're going to push there. I'm just going to do the water on my own, like by hand for now, because I don't think we're going to need that much hydrochloric acid, but we are going to need a little bit. Next step, we're going to steal that old electrolyzer that we haven't been using for a while and probably pick up that that trash can. Come on, thank you. Okay, then we'll bring that guy over here. Apparently there's a singular piece of chrome in there, and that's going to go in there to make more stainless steel eventually. So we're going to go ahead and auto-push this into an electrolyzer right there. Okay, and I didn't put any salt in there. Luckily for me, I've gotten salt from a... Well, I mean, I found a salt ore vein, but I haven't mined it yet. I did get 64 salt from a, like, LV loot bag or something. So that's going to mix into salt water, get pushed into here, if I do that. And it should begin electrolyzing if I give it a couple of these guys. No. This process requires a circuit on 11, and apparently it's, a little bit slower than I expected. I actually want to use a circuit on one so I get the chlorine down here and then I could push it directly into here. And what we want to do is essentially put the hydrogen directly back into the chlorine. And now that we're making hydrochloric acid, we can just shove that into a tank to be used at our leisure. Also, this sodium hydroxide stuff is actually fairly useful, so we're gonna put that back in the piggy bank. In order to make the next step, we're going to need an advanced chemical reactor once again. That's going to have this because I'm going to push into here. Yep, and then we're going to have we're going to have this and we're going to have cells. I'm making more cells so we can do more of these processes quicker, but now we're making iron 3 chloride. I already did my first batch, so let's go ahead and auto fluid output into that thing, and this will be where we store our backlog. What we need to make with these is these plastic circuit boards. They take, fortunately, only 250 liters or milliliters per, which means we can make 4 per 1, which means we can already make, 12 of these? Well, 12 mediums, because this is our first way to make mediums directly, and 24 of these, because we make them 2 at a time now. However, what we can also do is make these HV, these second tier, like the second HV circuit, like the slightly better ones, out of these new MV ones, which these can be turned into our first IV circuits, if I can find the recipe. Sorry, it's not IV, it's EV, but these are our first EV ones, which we're going to need a couple of, is it one of? We're going to need one of to make the schematic rocketeer for the dire crafting table to make our rockets. We're also going to need to figure out how to make one IV, which I think we can make with these first tier EV ones, but that's going to require HV power, which is going to have to be made using one of these. So this is what our next step is. Let's try and get two EV circuits so we can make the HV circuit assembling machine. And this last chemical reactor we have is going to be used right here. I'm going to need to use one of these other tanks. By the way, I crafted all this stuff in the interim. There was a cut somewhere a little while ago that was like 6 hours long, and I just did a ton of crafting. Okay, where's the sulfuric acid? Right here. So let me just actually go ahead and steal this, and then we can put another one down. But let's examine the... interesting. Right, there we go. All good to go. Let's go shove this into our chemical reactor. The first reaction we have to do requires polyethylene and a little bit of copper foil, and that will turn into the plastic boards. And then we need to turn those with some more copper foil into plastic circuit boards with sodium persulfate. While we're waiting for those to craft up, because they are going to take a minute, we can take some of these compressed air cells, which you can make by just putting some of these empty cells into a compressor, and slowly but surely it will fill with air. We can put these in the centrifuge, and 5 of them will turn into 4-ish buckets of nitrogen. It takes forever, but we need some nitrogen, and I'll probably just use a dolly to transport it. We need nitrogen to make the next tier of monocrystalline silicon wools. It requires a little bit of glowstone, a bunch of silicon, and 8 buckets of nitrogen per. And while I'm going to get this started now, we do have something we must do before we can put this nitrogen to use. If you check the recipe in here for... These guys, you can see the heat capacity is 2484. Our normal coils only go up to 1700, I believe. Or does it not show me? It doesn't show me. I believe it's 1700. Or no, 1800. And this is 2700, which means we can do it in the Canthal coils, but we need to make those. These have to just be blasted. I can actually make a bunch of it right now. It's just iron, aluminum, and chrome. But if you want to turn it into ingot form, it turns into hot ingot form, which means that you need to shove it through a cryogenic freezer or a vacuum freezer, whatever you want to call it. It's not a difficult thing to do. However, this multi-block is somewhat difficult. It takes a lot of aluminum and three IV tier circuits. So that's going to be another draw on our resources, but it's actually not that bad, I don't think. We can make these very soon, and we'll probably get onto that next episode. All right, there we go. The first 64 plastic circuit boards are done. Now we just need to react to these with more copper foil. So I need to start getting more of that cooking up in here, but we already have 64 right here, and I just need to allow this to push, right? And there we go. I'm fairly certain we're gonna get about 40 plastic circuit boards out of this, which is gonna help us get into what we need to get into next. However, I think that's gonna be everything for today. Let's go ahead and claim this reward, actually. It should be in the envy tab. I could have sworn. Oh no, I haven't had all this stuff in my inventory at once. So give me those, and give me that, and I need one polyethylene sheet, which should just be right here. And complete the quest. There we go, perfect. Okay, so let's give this back to him, that back to him. There we go, and let's claim our loot bag. Yeah, I want the loot bag. And let's open them up. I got three. Let's see what we got. It looks like I got a nice door. Is that it? Vanadium steel. Ooh, I'll probably make a wrench out of that. I lost my vanadium steel wrench when I accidentally did slash clear on my inventory. It looks like I got... That's it. Anyways, let's go ahead and call it there for today. I'm probably not going to do much in between episodes, but we are going to... I think we have everything we need to make the vacuum freezer and the implosion compressor next time. It's just going to require a little bit of crafting and a little bit more crafting. It's going to be annoying, but it's definitely doable. I'll probably actually need to smelt up a little bit more of this. I only have 128 and 34 in there, so I'm definitely going to need more aluminum, and I'm going to need to get this guy running once again once I... Do I have any machines running here? I do, which probably means I can't... run it right now. Once this is done, it's done right now. I will go ahead and soft hammer this and turn it back on. Perfect. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, maybe leave a like or something. Who really knows? And hopefully I'll see you next time. Have a fantastic day. Bye bye.